Can you believe that was me? Oh man, my, how times have changed. That's why I don't have an intro for this video. I ran out of time to make an intro because I was digging through some old stuff I hadn't seen in years, including, check this out. This is one of the first computer manuals ever written. Look at this. I even have programming notes I wrote in the book to help me figure out how computers work. But my favorite part is right here. If you make a mistake, don't worry. It's much easier to correct typing errors on the TRS-80 than on a regular typewriter. No rubber erasers or white paint to fuss with. Just use the backspace key, right? How cool is that? Anyway, no intro for you today, although I guess this was an intro. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal the Tech. Today we're taking a look at a feature on Fujifilm cameras called long exposure noise reduction. The setting is located right here in the IQ section of your menu. And it has two choices, either on or off. Now, according to Fujifilm, this setting will help to reduce noise when you're taking long exposures. Now, when I'm talking about reducing noise in your exposures, I'm not talking about the kind of noise that appears when you have way too high of an ISO value. If you shoot an ISO value of, say, above 3200, you will most likely see noise that looks like film grain. That is not what this setting is trying to prevent. Rather, according to Fujifilm, it is designed to reduce modeling that can occur in long exposure images. Sort of a cleaning of the blotchy areas that can sometimes appear across the image frame from the sensor as the sensor gets hotter and therefore noisier while you're taking long exposures. Now, what your camera's doing when you have long exposure noise reduction enabled is that once your first and main photo is finished, the camera will then automatically take a second photo, but of nothing but pure black, and for the same amount of time. So for example, let's say you're taking a 3-minute long exposure and then you have long exposure noise reduction enabled. The camera will then, as soon as you're finished with your 3-minute exposure, it will take another equally long exposure for 3 minutes of pure black. So basically you're now standing there for 6 minutes, right? Once it does that, it uses that black exposure, which can more easily show imperfections like hot pixels, etc., to know where to reduce those imperfections in your original exposure, and then it saves a final and more cleaned up exposure to your SD card. At least in theory. Let's take a look. Okay, right here I have two different 15-minute exposures. In other words, my shutter speed was set for 15 minutes. Both of them are using the lowest base ISO value and shot with the same lens at f/16. The image on the left was shot without the noise reduction turned on. The image on the right, I turned it on. I am now zoomed in 800%, and I am not seeing much of a difference at all. These raw images look identical. I mean identical. Now, let's look at the out-of-camera JPEGs. Same as before, exact same settings, except the one on the left has noise reduction turned off, and the one on the right has it turned on. Again, absolutely identical. So from this, I can tell you that if you shoot for 15 minutes at the base ISO value, you will see no difference whatsoever with noise reduction using that setting. But what happens if we crank up the ISO value? Here are two raw images taken with a 4-minute exposure time. Both of them have f/16 and both of them have an ISO value of 3200. And zooming in 800%, have a look at this. Pretty much identical. In fact, interestingly, the photo on the right, which has the noise reduction turned on, has this extra, whether it's a hot or defective pixel error, you see that right there? But these are just pretty much identical. I ran a number of other tests at different ISO values and different exposure times, and all the results I got for both raw and straight out of the camera JPEG files were the same. They looked identical to me, and if there were differences, they were so minor that you really have to be cranked in at 800 or more percent to see them. Now, one test I didn't do was aim it up at the stars at an extremely high ISO value and let it run for maybe 30 minutes. I did not have time and was not able to do that for this video, so I can't say if maybe I would have seen a more significant amount of noise reduced least if I had had those settings. But for those of you that are wondering about that and average use cases, no, I couldn't tell a difference. They looked identical to me for both RAW and JPEGs. Honestly, I never used this setting. And not just because I couldn't tell a difference in the shots that I showed you. First and most problematically, if you have long exposure noise reduction turned on, this will double the time it takes for you to get a shot. Imagine taking a 30-minute timed exposure, and then you need to sit there and wait another 30 minutes for the camera to take and process the long exposure noise reduction version. So yeah, doubling the time it takes to do each shot is a problem, at least for me. Secondly, there are other options for reducing noise in long exposures. Photoshop and Lightroom both have plugins like the Nick Collection or blending modes where you can use your own dark frame. And the advantage to using these methods, particularly dark frame, is that you can do so one time after your entire batch of shots and then process them later on. Now, going into these techniques is beyond the scope of today's Fast Friday video, but just know that there are additional benefits that you can do in post-production that go beyond this feature in the camera that is the long exposure noise reduction setting. Now, I'm not saying it's useless, and I'm sure for some of you and some of your shooting conditions, you may use this all the time. I would love to know. Please let me know in the comments if you use it, what you use it for, and if it's any benefit for you. And lastly, I want to thank all of you for responding to my Apple versus PC poll. You know, which do you use? That was one of the most helpful responses I've ever had on this channel. And the reason I asked it is because I want to know what direction to take my area of focus when I have to do screen demos, software installation tutorials, and things like that. And in the case of the Mac versus PC, because a majority of you said, yeah, we use PCs, well, look at what I got, okay? Added to the channel. My last PC purchase was in 2008. So this channel will use both platforms because you do. Well, thank you so much for watching, and I hope the video was helpful or entertaining or something else to you. And if it was, please be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I will be signing off now. Have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you in a brand new video next week. Take care.